G'day and welcome back to Buildsum, and this is part 7 of the series on calculating wall bracing, and this time we're looking at how many bracing units we actually need for the walls that we're going to put in. Okay, so you should be pretty familiar with this information. Basically, we needed 26.758 kilonewtons of force, of resistance, in wind direction 1. So I'm going to choose bracing method H, or bracing H with a method B fixing, which gives me a total resistance of 6 kilonewtons per meter. Okay, and that's apply bracing method. So each sheet will be 1.2 meters wide, so 6 times 1.2 gives me 7.2 kilonewtons per sheet. So if I know that I can get 7.2 kilonewtons out of a sheet, all I have to do is divide the 26.78 by 7.2, and that tells me I need 3.7 sheets of ply to get my required bracing. So I'm going to say I need 4 sheets of ply bracing fixed using method H, or requirement H, method B fixing. Okay, so 4 sheets on that for wind direction 1. Wind direction 2, we needed 10.127 kilonewtons of resistance. Again, I'm going to use the same bracing method, so we're not having to worry too much about changing things through the job site. So I know it gives me 7.2 kilonewtons per sheet. We needed 10, so 10 divided by 2.7, 7.2 equals 1.4, so I need 2 sheets in wind direction 2. So there we go, all up at the moment, I need 6 sheets of ply for my bracing. Okay, a couple other little rules that come up. So the minimum length of any plywood bracing panel should be 900. Okay, and remember, if you change the width to 900, then your bracing capacity is going to diminish, because it's, you know, its bracing capacity is per meter rate. The only exception to that would be for fixing type, or for bracing type H, which is ply, with method A fixing. Okay, you can get down to 600. Alright, so however, for a panel of 600, the bracing capacity should be half that of a 900 panel. So what you have to do to work the bracing capacity out for that is you would work out what a 900 panel was, and you would halve it. Okay, and then if you wanted to get really picky and you had a panel length of, say, 750, you could calculate, okay, that capacity, right? So you'd work out, you know, what the difference was between a 900 sheet and a 600 sheet, and you could actually calculate the capacity. It would work up incrementally based on the length of your panel. Okay, but that's just a little side note. So anyway, we know we need 6 sheets now. That's what it actually works out. But there are a couple of other little rules that we have to adhere to, and I'll cover those in the next video. G'day, I'm back. Just to let you know that if you like this video, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel, or you can follow me on Facebook so you don't miss out on more great videos.